Hi everyone, welcome back to Kevin's Corner. I appreciate it's been a while. We've been filming, but just haven't had a chance to put stuff together yet. So, later than advertised, but we're happy to celebrate that we made it to 100 subscribers. In such a short amount of time, it's so nice to be able to share this experience with so many other people that think he's as cool as I do. So we've popped in with him today. What will follow this will be footage that's been shot over the last week or so. But I did want to cover why we have Kevin. There's a number of people ask, and obviously it isn't ideal to have a wild animal in captivity. However, as some of you might remember, he's quite small for a magpie. I believe had nature taken its course when he was kicked out of the nest as a fledgling, it's unlikely he would have made it, but he was found and hand-reared. And so he did survive. Unfortunately, when they tried to release him, he didn't have a good experience with other birds and got attacked quite a bit. And so sort of imprinted on humans as people that like me aren't very nice to me, but these humans feed me. So he was taken to the sanctuary that I adopted him from, where I believe it was four separate attempts to release him were carried out, and in their records it's released, crossed out, because he just comes back. So he wouldn't survive in the wild. So he needed somewhere to live. And so he's come to live with me. And that's the story of why we have Kevin. Also to update you, because this is the latest video I've shot in here, we have added some decor. Some of the old cut down conifer trees from over the back there I've brought in. And as you can see, he quite likes them. Hi. Hello. Did you get a boop? That's my treat. We've got some more foliage around here as well. I'm going to bring some more in, but I've found that major changes unsettle him, whereas gradual ones, and then give him some time to get used to them, he's a lot happier. Thank you. Miss some. I'm not giving you any more. He's not actually hungry now, he's just being greedy. Yeah. Where are you going to go with them? Hi. So, yeah. As I was saying, thank you to all, I think it's a bit more than 100 now, I think it's 105, 106 of you that enjoy this enough to want to see more. And I hope you like some of the clips that follow this. And here's to hopefully 100 more. Hi everybody, welcome back to a very special Kevin's Corner. We have broken 100 subscribers and we can't believe it. And the enthusiasm and the response we've had just to Kevin has been incredible. This all just started out as me just wanting to journal what is a once-in-a-lifetime experience, getting to look after and hang out with and just be with an animal like Kevin. It's been wonderfully fulfilling, so the enthusiasm we get is extra special. So now that we've got a nice break in the weather, we've actually got some sunshine for a change, we're going to spend a good amount of time with Kevin today and celebrate with him. It's cleaning day as well. Let's get in there and see how he's doing. Hello mate, so we're inside. I'm gonna sit with him a bit. Down he comes. First things first, Kevin. What's going on? Got some breakfast? Hi. Come on. Come get some breakfast. Why are you being weird? Where are you? So Kevin is strangely nervous about this. Something about the string seems to be freaking him out. First time it's happened, I'm not sure what he thinks is going on. You've seen videos with him with this before and he's been fine. He's fine with the local blackbirds here and a couple of magpies that visit. But there's the occasional bird that will come over, but he changes completely. He makes himself really small, will hide in the more sheltered areas of the aviary until he's sure they've gone. And every so often I'll bring something new in here and he's just not sure. I bring the jet washer in here and clean stuff, and he's curious and wants to see it, even though, you know, it could hurt him. I bring in certain toys or things of a certain colour. He's very unsure, still working on his confidence. I often just come and sit in here like this and just let him potter about. But it is curious why he's not so keen on his thing today. I managed to get him to come and take one Mario worm by opening it for him. But something about this string's really got him spooked. So if he doesn't improve in a second, I am just going to take it off so he can have the rest of his food. Kevin! Come on. Oh, lovely. Love how you do that for the cameras. Come on. It's definitely that string. It's not me, because I want to pull the treats out. Hi. I did wonder if he was upset with me, because every so often he'll get in a mood with me. If I've not had a chance to be in with him as much as I normally am. I'll be a bit aloof for a bit. But he's been fine today. Come on. If I bring it on my lap. No, Come off. Come on. The worm's right there. You can't have the treat bag. Look, there's a worm there. Kevin, look. He's really not sure. So if I'm right, if I take the string off this, he'll be fine. But let's give him another second to see what's in here. Come on. It's my finger, you can't eat it. It's not me, something about this. It's your favourite puzzle. Worms. Come on. There you go. One more. Good. How strange. Come in. Come here, come see me. Hello. They're not in that pocket. He's so mischievous now. It's hard to do things with one hand because he's always getting into them. Hi. Thank you. What a long way you've come. Should we get ready to clean? Oh, I think there might be a pellet about to come up. I'm not giving it any more. What are you watching? And now you're not afraid of it. You've still not noticed there's worms in there. And now you have. How bizarre. Thank you. You remember now? He's realised it's not going to eat him again. Unless you do that and drop it on your own foot. That's strange. I'm glad he got over whatever it was anyway. God, I love his colours. Good. Hi. Right, well, let's get ready to clean, shall we? This has become a new hangout spot for us. Up by his bed, where he'll stay and play a little. Don't you? What's under there? Hey? It's kind of cool. It's working with him like this, it seems like there's instinct versus the trust that he's building. Because he will come and do this. Let me touch his beak. If I then play and go to touch him, he's not sure. But he comes back. Give him. He nearly fell off. What really often shows the instinct versus what he thinks is when vision, when his vision's impaired, like when it's dark, he lets me pet him because he doesn't have the sight of the thing coming towards him. So he's very not sure, but he comes back. It's a lovely thing with him, isn't it? See? Isn't that? This is all him. There's no food hidden. Where are you going to go? Up there. Hello. And come back. Hey. Hello. Come in. He tries so hard. Hey. So far, and it's been 2 months, not even 2 months, more like a month and a half. He's been here with me. And you'll see from the clips that I'll add here just how far he's come in that time, how nervous he was. And look, he runs off, and then he comes back. Come on. Come in. And from being nervous to even come near my leg while it was loaded with treats, So the way he comes hopping over now when he knows I've brought breakfast for him. It's an incredible experience. Hey.
Hey.
Favourite game he plays, which is hard to film, is when he runs around my back.
Hey. Hey. Oh. What?
He plays this game where he runs around and then comes back. He does it around my back. He runs to one side till I turn to look at him, and then he runs to the other. Lovely. I'm sure everyone on camera loves seeing that. Hey. Hello. Fascinating bird. Anyway, let's go and get ready for cleaning, shall we? Oh, it's a proper full clean day today. A normal cleaning day means we come in, spray down, jet wash all this. Fresh water, fresh food, that gets jet washed down, so does all this. And up there gets wiped down. Full clean, which is done every other time, is his toys and stuff come inside and they get washed in nice hot water. Just keep everything sanitary for him. I started playing with hay recently as well. I'm not sure what that's about.
It's your hay. Have to look and see if you need clean hay.
And the other thing we're going to do is we're going to change his roost box today. He doesn't make as much use of it as I'd like, and I think some of that is because it's quite dark in there and very blue. And I have learned that birds' colour vision is a lot more vivid than ours. So I'm going to take this off, cut some windows in it, and put a better covered box on top that's easier to clean off. Because while this does wipe clean easily enough, he's a little bugger and has pecked a load of holes in it, haven't you?
My finger. You can't eat my finger.
Look at the bravery.
Look at the bravery. Look how brave.
Kevin is very much one that can give it but not take it.
Acha.
It's so cute. Everything clean and drying. Time for a coffee break.
Hey, buddy.
So, currently dismantling his roost box to make some changes to it. He's very excited and curious. Don't know what to make of it at all. He has been shouting at my stuff. Doesn't seem to mind my drill. He did have a shout at the box when I brought it in. He's so cool. Yeah, I'm just going to take this down so we can cut some windows in it and put a better cover on it. I'm going to keep a cover because when it's cold, that's where I pop the heating pad for him. So, right, Let's get this taken apart. Right, that's the bulk of that done. Hey buddy. This is gonna move now. What do you think of that? Right. That's all that set up now. Let's see what he makes of the new setup. Hey, what do you make of all this then? He's so cute. Okay, I need my Dremel to recharge to finish the housework. So we're gonna do the deep cleaning here now. And Kevin something to play with. Make a good noise. Anyway, let's deep clean in here. Okay. I'll see you folks when I'm done. This is impossible to do one-handed. Yeah, buddy. And he'll just watch me from here. Supervise, won't ya? Yeah, buddy. Oh. Right then, let's set your stuff down. There you go, mate. I'm in a preen. Inspecting his food. Oh, straight for the chicken. First time I've given him chicken breast before. Seems to approve. Oh, now it's time to hide it. Joy, good job I've cleaned up in here, isn't it? Oh no, not hiding it, just picking pieces off. Awesome. They're nice. Oh, yes. Very good. Is that good stuff? That's so cool. Is that nice? Is it playtime again? Hi. That's everything clean now. Fresh food, fresh water, water bath, and freshly packed Kong with peanut butter, which he really likes. Yeah. Come on. Wedge that in there for him and he'll go after that. Right, mate, I am going to finish off your house. I will be back. All right, my friend. What do you think of that? I like the noises they make, don't you? Right, I'll see you when you get your new house. Dremel should be charged now. Let's go put some windows in it. Right, so it took a little while, as you can see, a bit short on sunshine as we're approaching dusk. But the modifications to the house are done. As you see, we've got a window around here where there was none before, and one on the other side. Just there. And made a little flap here because that's where I'll put his heat pad when he needs one. And that's a stronger box. And also, this top part I've used Velcro to secure it. And this is all laminated now, so I can just unpop this off the top, wipe it clean, and then put it back up again. So it's a lot easier to keep his favourite sleeping spot clean. So let's go and fit it now and see what he thinks. Okay, see how this big brave magpie's liking his house. It's almost dusk here now. Well, he's gone up by it and he's not too scared of it. That's good. Let's see if he'll come for some treats before I leave him for the night. So there it is, all in place. His window. Those windows are glazed with acetate on the outside and double on the inside, so he's got triple glazing. He's got better windows than our house. So as you can see, there's a piece there and there's a piece on the other side of the box, as well as a piece on this side here. So hopefully he'll like that. And there's his removable cap, so he can crap up there to his heart's content and I can easily clean it the following day. Hey, looking for some treats. I'm doing them up here, so you're gonna have to come get some. Oh, finally, after some coaching and encouragement, he's made it on top of his box. Oh, he'll be okay now. Good night, Kev. Morning, buddy. There you go, back to normal today.
playing with your food. There we go. A knife. No. Oh.
Can hear another magpie call. I'm sure you can hear it as well. Right, Kev, I'm gonna go get your other treat.
Hello, mate. What have I got here?
You remember.
Come on. Hey. Hey. Hello. You got a chick down there. Feel a little tail wiggle. Oh, he's standing on one leg. Are you getting warm? Eh?
Well, I'm going to leave this here and enjoy this time with him. Because he's got all small and he's on one leg to get warm off me. He's sitting now. Great place to end it. Welcome to all of our, well, 105 subscribers now. Here's to more. And thank you everyone for sharing this experience with me.